Good afternoon. Many of you probably know I come from New York City, and back when I was a kid, I used to travel with my dad on a commuter rail from Long Island into Manhattan. Switch over and get onto the subway. This is really exciting to see this train here, which is a commuter rail, and the possibility of extending the rail all the way from Santa Fe to Mexico, down through Las Cruces and into El Paso. We held a joint city council meeting a couple of weeks ago, and we think there's about 17,000 commuters a day that could take advantage of this rail system that could be extended down this far. Congressman Teague from New Mexico has introduced some legislation that would be very beneficial, but authorize the study of extending the rail. So we're extremely excited. It's really more exciting when you have the train behind you, if you can feel it, touch it. And you just think about our investment in infrastructure, the typical infrastructure that we use. For example, the $96 million worth of stimulus money that we use give us several more interchanges at every little American from I-10. And the fact that this was about an $80 million really starts to make a lot of sense if you look at the long-term scheme. Eventually, people are going to want to park their personal vehicles and take the commuter rail. As the price of gasoline continues to skyrocket, as we look for alternative methods of transportation, the commuter rail makes more and more sense every day. So I'm glad to see that we have so many people in the transportation industry. Roy Gilliard from the Metropolitan Planning Organization, John Perry from the Texas Department of Transportation, our elected officials that are here supporting the concept of commuter rail between our two great cities, Las Cruces and El Paso, and extending all the way up to the capital of Mexico, Santa Fe. With that, I'll turn it back. Any of the other people here would like to make some comments in regards to this very exciting project. You're never ever lost for work.
Well, it's definitely very exciting to finally get to a point where we're actually talking about commuter rail and about more efficient and environmentally friendly modes of transportation. And I didn't prepare to speak, but what I can say is that we really do, as a nation, need to move more towards transportation that is better to our environment and that requires less investment in roads, in more and more and more roads. We need to look more towards rail, we need to look more towards mass transit, and this would definitely get us there. I think, you know, another aspect of this that is very exciting is that many of us who were brought up in this area know it more as a region, and we really don't see a whole lot of boundaries and borders between the communities, whereas other folks might. And so this, I think, would help create that interconnectedness within the region that most of us really want to see taken advantage of. And so this is very exciting. I really hope that there's a way that we can turn this into a reality. I would like for the city to include the county in as many of the conversations as possible so that we can all come together and look for these really exciting modes of transportation. But thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Representative on the west side, one of them. This is extremely
basically that we have here today is, it's really involved a lot of people working behind the scenes to develop a multimodal transportation system for the El Paso region, and the region is beyond just El Paso County. As you well know, across the river we have 1.5 million people in the city of Juarez that will also use this commuter rail facility once we get it established between El Paso, Las Cruces, and Albuquerque. The mayor mentioned that there were approximately 18,000 people that travel between Las Cruces and El Paso on a daily basis that would use this facility. 30% of those people reside in the city of Juarez. So as we move forward, we must continue to remain focused in our efforts and work together as a community to accelerate the actual implementation of this project. This is just a demonstration project here today. We have a lot of work ahead of us. I think we have the political support that never existed before. We need to take advantage of that support, both from the county as well as from the city, as well as all of the transportation providers that are in this region. So with that, as the regional planner for transportation, I'm excited at this opportunity, and I'm really looking forward to working with the administrations that we have in place here today. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. My name is Chuck Berry. I'm the district engineer for TxDOT in El Paso. I think TxDOT, rail. We are the state's transportation agency. We have a lot of responsibilities, and some of them include the statewide rail plan. And it's projects that are similar to what New Mexico has done that could be evaluated for our own region. TxDOT's goals include the safe movement of people and goods. And future projects like what this could represent that New Mexico has done, and the possibility of commuter traffic between Las Cruces and El Paso, is something that we need to have considered for our own future here in Texas and for our Camino Real regional area between Las Cruces and El Paso, Ciudad Juarez. We're glad to see a lot of you here. I'd like to thank the New Mexico DOT and the Las Cruces MPO folks for arranging for this thing to happen so that we could all see what the possibilities are for our own future. Thank you, Mayor.
I see why you got the drop.
Thank you, Mayor. First of all, the mayor and local elected officials, commissioners and councilors, and members of the press, on behalf of Governor Bill Richardson and the state of New Mexico, we are more than happy to be here today to bring this equipment to El Paso, to give the citizens of El Paso, give all of you an opportunity to look at what modern-day commuter rail systems look like and how they function, really. Even in rural communities, states like New Mexico, rural communities like Belen, Los Santas, and some of the smaller communities that we have. So I think one of the important issues to think about is that commuter rail doesn't mean that you have to be in an urban area the size of Los Angeles or New York to have an efficient commuter system. What it means is making a commitment to the environment, making a commitment to the people that are in your communities, and really planning for the future. And Governor Bill Richardson's project of the commuter rail connecting Santa Fe to Albuquerque and the community south and in between those two major cities was really a commitment to New Mexico's future and to giving people a choice to get out of their car and use an alternative transportation system. And I will tell you all that it's been a tremendous success. People enjoy the system, and once people get an opportunity to experience it, they don't want to go back to their four-wheel drive vehicles or SUVs. They want to be in a system that's safe, efficient, comfortable, and quite frankly gives them a quality of life that's very different. We all know what driving our congested roads can mean to just your day-to-day quality of life. But with that, Mayor, and particularly thanks to Senator Shapley's office, Daniel, thanks for coordinating all of this. We're more than happy to bring it, and we'll be happy to answer any questions. And again, the last piece I would say is, we are extremely interested in this project from the state of New Mexico's perspective because of the connection between Las Cruces and El Paso. There are two major communities in a growing region, and having something of this magnitude planned today and built today will only make it more affordable for our children in the future to really enjoy what is going to be, I think, a very big, big economic market for New Mexico and for this part of the great state of Texas. So thank you for having us.
Daniel has thank you very much for all coming out here and standing in the sun. I hope that once this press conference is over, you guys can go inside and take a look at the beautiful train and cool off a little bit. My name again is Daniel Collins. I'm the Communication Director for Senator Eliot Shapleigh. He wishes that he could be here himself, but as many of you probably already know, he's actually busy in Austin working through the rest of the session, which I plan to be at this month. I did have a few remarks I'd like to make on his behalf. First, I'd like to also still thank Mayor John Cook and the City of El Paso, as well as the Mid-Region Council of Governments for helping to coordinate this event. Rob could tell us what the rail runner possible without their assistance. I did also have some prepared remarks from the Senator. The El Paso Del Norte region is the largest metropolitan area along the U.S.-Mexico border, resting at the intersection of three states and two countries. Our region is now among the largest international commuter and commercial ports in the Western Hemisphere. In order to remain a successful port, enhanced mobility in the region has become increasingly more important. In 2007 alone, there were more than 23 billion border crossings for pedestrians, commuter, and commercial trucks. Today, about 18,000 people commute every day between Las Cruces and El Paso, and about 30% of those come from the waters. A part of our future success with the mobility puzzle is international commuter rail and mass transit. In its earliest years, the El Paso Del Norte region was an international leader in commuter rail. In 1901, the El Paso Electric Company had begun electric streetcar options, running a city streetcar system that was 35 miles long by the year 1907. El Paso was a sleepy town of just about 737 people, but after rail started in El Paso in 1 month, from May to June in 1881, the El Paso population jumped from 700 to about 1500. In 1974, the last year that El Paso had an electrified rail system between El Paso and Juarez, the rail system was running about 11,000 people every day between our two cities. Today, as our representatives have already mentioned, as gas prices continue to increase, mobility options are going to be more and more important for us to become the city of Reno. In Dallas and other cities around Texas, we're already seeing these mobility options underway, particularly in Austin. In the El Paso region, meeting the challenge of mobility in El Paso North is just as important as meeting the challenge of a new medical school or base realignment. New trade represents new opportunities and new challenges. How reduce congestion and pollution, increase trade mobility, define us against all ports in the rest of the Americas. A presidential application is presently being prepared by the Quebecian Border Commission to create an international rail freight corridor between the general area of New Mexico through the Santa Teresa, Grande New Mexico area, to the Assembly of Chihuahua in Mexico. This international freight corridor will provide a service to Aeromex, BNSF, and Union Pacific Rail Companies. The estimated 50 miles of track in Juarez and the El Paso MPO study is expected to provide for economic growth in the region and alleviate traffic congestion on existing road facilities and that intersect with rail traffic. This presents a historic opportunity for El Paso. In the future, the existing rail in Juarez, being relocated to Santa Teresa, could be used to expand commuter rail between our two cities once again. And we can create a freight line similar to what Governor Richardson created with the railroad which you see behind us. By working together, we can do exactly what New Mexico did. We can take existing rail and adapt its new use as state-of-the-art commuter rail to better define our bi-national region. Senator Shapleigh would again like me to thank Governor Richardson and thank the Mid-Region Council of Governments and the Mexico Railroad for bringing this to pass on. Thank all the members of the City and Council for participating today. And thank you all.
As you can see, the political leadership and the administrative leadership that's here is excited about this project. With that, we'll open it up to any questions.